So our need statement is a way to rapidly and reliably decompress the intestine in non-operatively managed patients with suspected adhesive small bowel obstruction in order to reduce operation rates and reduce hospital stay. And so typically when we have a need statement like this, we would find an opportunity to scope the need statement up and down. So actually to test the specificity of the statement in terms of the population and the outcome and say, should we broaden or narrow the population and outcome to make sure that we've really found for us the sweet spot in terms of who and what we want to target and the need we're addressing.
One way you might scope this need up to reach a broader population would be if you said a way to rapidly and reliably decompress the intestine in all patients with suspected small bowel obstruction in order to reduce hospital stay. So any patient that comes with a small bowel obstruction, regardless of whether they're actually non-operatively managed, could fall under this need statement. The reason why we ended up focusing on the original need statement was because patients who go down the non-operatively managed track have a lot more variability in how they're treated, whereas patients who tend to get operations generally get treated exactly the same way, and the algorithm is quite different. So the specific patients we wanted to focus on were the ones who could be non-operatively managed.
Another way that you could target a different scoping is actually to look at, we looked at patients with suspected adhesive small bowel obstructions, and we could scope it up in including all the patients who present to the ER with abdominal pain instead of just those with adhesive small bowel obstructions. So the problem with that is, and the reason why we ended up on this need is we wanted to narrow down our population to the appropriate market, and we also recognized that in the clinical flow of things and the way that things happen in the ER, it just makes sense to apply a therapy once the adhesive small bowel obstruction was recognized as being the underlying problem.
One way we could scope this need statement down is to not just focus on patients with suspected adhesive small bowel obstruction, but actually patients that have had prior ASBOs, because that's a subset of patients that have suspected ASBOs. So the effect of that would be potentially knowing more with more certainty that the patient suffered from the condition we're trying to treat. However, we might be excluding patients that could broaden the scope of our treatment by doing that.
So as we scope our needs, you know, up and down in the population and the outcome, whenever we would alter one element of the need statement, we would need to go back and look at the whole need statement, because if you alter your population, that may actually change what outcome you need to focus on. So it really is an art when it comes to scoping needs up and down and not a science. And it's the team's job to kind of figure out what the best iteration of that need is for them to go forward in terms of the appropriate market they want to target that will have adequate size but also allow them to understand the problem enough to come up with a viable solution.